Hey everyone, welcome back to my garden, and today we got an update with the mouse melon plant. As you see, if you've been following this growth and watching these episodes, you see that this plant is looking very different from last week. And a lot of the leaves have been clipped back and trimmed away. Basically all the dead leaves, as you see here. I came in and I clipped them back and freed up a lot of space for a lot of new growth to come in. If we take a look, you can see a lot of small new leaves forming everywhere. So it definitely will be filled in pretty soon, so I'm not worried about it looking nice and sparse like you see it is at the moment. And basically all of the leaves that you see here that are beginning to dry out, like you see back there, let me zoom in a little bit with the dark marks right there. All of the leaves that dry out are basically the ones that have no longer have fruits producing on them. So there's no energy that's being pumped into anything. So it's being redirected back into the plant, and that leaf is dying off. So you could technically come in and give this plant a nice little trim and clip back all of the dead leaves that you see, as long as there's no fruit still being produced on it. Let me show you an example. Like if we come into here, as you see right here, there is basically a leaf that's connected. Right next to it is a fruit that's produced, and this leaf absorbs all of the energy and it pumps it back into this fruit right here. So as long as that's there, it's gonna keep growing and getting nice and big and plump. Now, if we take a look right over here, for example, you see this fruit right over here? This is nice and dried out. So this didn't pollinate properly. The flower that we used probably didn't have enough of pollen in it, and it didn't take compared to like this fat plump one or this fat plump one right here. So look, by simply even just a little touch, usually it just falls right off. This one's a little harder. Oh, there you go. Now you have this leaf right here basically that will be redirecting its energy into the rest of the vine. But being that there's no fruit there, you could come in and clip this off, and it will give more energy and more space back into the rest of the plant to grow, and allow the rest of the fruits to produce instead of the leaves growing, because I want all the production to be pumping back into the fruit to get them nice and plump and big for me. This way we don't have to wait a long time to eat delicious fruits, as well as I didn't forget about all of you that have signed up to get free seeds to try to get the competition. Don't worry, there's gonna be plenty of seeds for all of you. I'm gonna try to give as many seeds as I can and store as many as possible. So unfortunately, I'm not gonna eat as many as I want in this first grow, because I wanna share with everyone and share with my friends, since this is the first time I'm growing something like this. And yeah, I mean, I have another one already growing, so I'm perfectly fine to share most of this plant. And for every single person basically that has left a comment and hit the like, as well as subscribed, most likely you're going to be getting seeds in the mail as soon as they're available. So just be patient and give me a little time. And let's get back to the plant here. So this plant has been growing for a long time now, and the fruits are almost ready for to be harvested, some of them. If we move around, you could see some nice beautiful ones, as well as some dried up ones that didn't actually pollinate. You can't get them all, but we do our best. And being that this is an indoor grow, we're hand pollinating all of these flowers here, so that's why some of them that are missed in the back, for example, the ones that are harder to get to, being that this is in a little greenhouse. those might be missed every now and then and will fall off, but that's okay because everywhere where there's ones that fall, there'll be new fruits being produced. Look at this little tiny cucumelon right there. And these things are basically all over the place. And if you remember earlier, I mentioned when you come in and you clip off the main branches, the main vines, it sends off all these side shoots. That definitely works. And I've noticed that the more you come in and the more you clip this plant, the more this thing keeps on growing. And it truly is an amazing little vine plant. It produces for me very, very well. And I'm even thinking about taking this plant and putting it outside of my greenhouse, outside of my two greenhouses here, really, and letting it grow basically up all around my entire greenhouse here. This way, when you come in, it's going to be from the outside. I want to possibly put maybe a string of rope going all the way around and have the cucumber growing as it is here, going up to my higher second level there, right behind the fan. Tomatoes are doing quite well. It's looking like a crazy jungle in there at the moment. And we've refilled this plant basically for the nutrients. The reservoir I've refilled already, I believe, 3 times now. And it's definitely coming up to the fourth refill moment. If we pull this plant out, look at all those dead leaves back there that fell. Let me show you. We always refill the nutrients basically back up to the 1500 mark. And it's currently right over here. So it's doing quite well. Let's see if we could see the roots. Nice and big. And coming up to the stem, look at this. Developing even further. And you could see that this thing is aging and starting to look pretty strange, I think. And let's just zoom around, see what it looks like. And yeah, so for those of you that are growing this plant, you could expect it to produce heavy, grow all over the place, and you're going to have a lot of fun growing this plant. And if you have any questions, leave them down below. I'll do my best to answer everything. And don't forget to hit the thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching.